Welcome to TripuraIndia.com. This is Momita. I will discuss about diabetes. Near to me, Dr. Shapan Sarkar, MBBS, MSc, DMB, Medicine. What is diabetes?
Diabetes is a disease where there is relative or absolute deficiency of insulin in the body. There is associated insulin resistance. As a result, there is increased blood sugar level.
Is there any types of diabetes?
There are different types of diabetes.
And what are they?
Mostly, there are two types. Type 1 diabetes mellitus and type 2 diabetes mellitus. Type 1 diabetes mellitus is seen in the children. And there is absolute deficiency of insulin in the children's body. And therefore, the children has to thrive on insulin given exogenously.
Is there any difference between type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes? Type 2 diabetes,
there is either relative deficiency of insulin or insulin is secreted but it cannot act at the periphery level. There is insulin resistance. The patient actually do not require insulin most of the time. But if there are some complications or there is a disease process for a long time, they may require insulin.
What is prevalence of diabetes?
You know, in 1995, World Health Organization has declared diabetes mellitus as an epidemic disease. It is projected that by 2030, there will be about 380 million people will suffer from diabetes across the world. And India has been declared as the diabetes capital of the world in 1995. It is expected that about 80 million people will suffer from diabetes in India. But it is also projected that in China, by 2030, near about 92 million people will suffer. Therefore, the diabetes capital of the world is going to be shifted from India to China. About 10% people in the country is suffering from diabetes. Our state is not also different. Though there is no definite survey for diabetes in Tripura, ICMR is taking up a survey, and it is expected that 10% of the people in Tripura do suffer from diabetes.
Does having diabetes mean that it is a higher risk in for other medical problems?
You see, the blood sugar is controlled, well controlled in diabetes mellitus. Complications sets in very late. But if it is not controlled, complications sets in. There are two types of complications in diabetes mellitus. One is microvascular complications, where there is kidney is involved, retina is involved, nerve is involved. There are microvascular complications also in the form of coronary artery disease, that is heart disease, also peripheral vascular diseases. Diabetes patients do suffer from lots of complications. It has been said that near about 2 to 3 times heart complication is there in diabetes patient. Then the patients not having diabetes mellitus. There are about 20 to 25 times more complications of the retina in comparison to the person not having diabetes mellitus. Also, they do suffer from 5 times more kidney complications. There is also 30 times more foot complications in diabetes mellitus. Foot ulcer is very common and is very costly to treat the foot ulcers in diabetic patient.
How diabetes is treated?
Main part of the treatment of diabetes mellitus is a lifestyle modification. The patient should have their normal weight. They should not be obese. They should restrict their diet. The balanced diet they should take. They should not take more carbohydrate diet. Three major meals, 3 snacks, 3 hours apart is the mode of treatment. They should lose weight if they are overweight. This is lifestyle modifications. And they should take plenty of fruits and vegetables. Fruits or vegetables which they can take. And if it is not controlled with the lifestyle modification, they should do some sort of exercise. Exercise in the form of 30 minutes morning walk or evening walk. Or they can do jogging, swimming, cycling as they do like. But there is some requirement of the drugs, either in the form of oral drugs or insulin. If patients have type 1 diabetes, there is no role of oral drugs. They have to continue insulin for their life. And type 2 diabetes mellitus patient, if along with the lifestyle modifications and your exercise, oral drugs, if blood sugar is not controlled, as I said earlier also, if there is some sort of complications like stroke, coronary artery disease, some foot infections, retinopathy, nephropathy, kidney or eye is involved, then they do care insulin. Insulin is the only treatment for diabetes mellitus in complicated case, we have to remember. And it is also said that Sometimes two diabetic patients, if the blood sugar is very high and they come with some other complications or may not be without complications, their age is very young, they are either 25 years, it has been said that if insulin is initiated very early, there is metabolic memory in their body and their future blood sugar control is very good in comparison to the patients who are not given insulin early.
Is insulin is only treatment for diabetes?
Yeah, for type 1 diabetic patients, insulin is the only treatment. There is no other treatment along with lifestyle modifications, diet and exercise. And for type 2 diabetic patients, as I said, they often require insulin. If the duration of diabetes is more, you know, let me tell you the pathogenesis of diabetes mellitus. You see this from the pancreas, beta cell, insulin is secreted. By the time diabetes is detected, near about 50% of the beta cell restriction is there, 50% efficacy of the beta cell function exists in the body, and blood sugar starts rising, insulin also reduced by 50%. In FDA, it is said, in a diabetic patient, there is 4% reduction of the beta cells. That means, by the time diabetes is detected, 50% insulin secretion is lost or less. And by that time, 12 to 14 years, there will not be any secretion of the insulin from the body. Therefore, this type of the people, type 2 diabetic mellitus patient, has to depend on diabetes, on insulin. And you see, I also told you, very high blood sugar in young patients, or the patients coming with some other complications in the form of retinopathy, nephropathy, some infections in the body, food infections, it's quite common in diabetic patients, we have to start insulin initially.
Is there any role of exercise?
Yes, definitely. There is a role of exercise. I told you initially that there is associated insulin resistance in type 2 diabetic mellitus patients. If the patient does some exercise, there will be better utilization of insulin peripherally in the body, and also it alleviates the insulin resistance. It also helps to reduce the body weight of the patient, and also it gives a feeling of well-being to the patient.
How can exercise make a difference from diabetes?
You see, exercise is a must for a diabetic patient. American Diabetes Association has advocated near about 30 to 45 minutes of morning or evening walk, 5 days in a week. But in our practice, we have advised the patients to do some sort of morning walk, 30 minutes per day, without skipping any day. They may also take up your swimming, as I told you, jogging, and also cycling, if possible. And also, they can have some sort of your exercise for 30 minutes, I told you, some sort of warming up of the body, then active aerobic exercise, then there will be near about 10 minutes cooling for the body.
What is the importance of diet in diabetes?
Diet plays an important role in the control of diabetes mellitus. You see, recently we have taken up a survey in the 10 centers across the country. Agartala, our Sarkar Diabetes Nutrition Clinical Research Center is the center for that. Next is in Eastern Zone is SSKM Hospital, where Dr. Professor Swatinath Mukherjee is the investigator. Across the country, there are 10 centers. The principal investigator of the study is Professor Shashank Joshi, is professor and head endocrinology in Lilavati Hospital, Bombay. So in this study, the study's name is STARS study. In the study, you have seen that whether the patient belongs to Agartala, Kolkata, Delhi, Chennai or Bangalore, most of our diabetic patients take more carbohydrate than they do require in comparison to the Western world patients. So therefore, if they take more carbohydrate food, their postprandial, that is after food blood sugar is very high in comparison to Western world, and it has been seen that if the PP blood sugar is high, there are lots of complications. Complications are more in diabetic patients. There are more complications like your heart disease is more common. Our patients are taking lots of carbohydrate, and it is also seen that near about 33% in the study, 33% of the patients, they do have control of the diabetes, and near about 38% of the patients, they adhere to the dietic advice of their physician. Therefore, vast majority of the patients, they do not adhere to the dietic regime, therefore blood sugar is not controlled in our country, and PP blood sugar remains very high, and also complications are high in comparison to the Western world.
What particular diet do you advise to the patient?
You see, if the diabetic patient is not having any complications, there is hardly any restrictions of the diet. Diet also will depend on the type of the physical work the patients perform. Actually, for a sedentary worker, male, we advise 1800 kilocalorie diabetic diet, and for female, near about 600 kilocalorie diabetic diet. Diet should be divided with three measurements: breakfast, lunch, and dinner, equal calorie, and they should take snacks 3 hours apart. Three measurement and three snacks 3 hours apart. They should not take very simple carbohydrate in the form of sugar and molasses, honey. They should also should not take much carbohydrate. Out of the 1800 kilocalorie, carbohydrate should not give more than 60% of the calorie, and they should not consume more fat. Fat calorie should be less than 30%, and protein will be near about 12 to 15%. They may take vegetarian diet, they may take also non-vegetarian diet. In Bengali community, most of the people are non-vegetarian, but across the country, most of the people are vegetarian. They should take lots of salads and fiber food.
What are some effects of uncontrolled diet?
Diet is uncontrolled. You see, this patient will gain weight, the blood sugar will be uncontrolled, there will be lots of complications. Particularly, the patient is having some sort of kidney problem, they should restrict water, they should restrict your salt, they should not take much pulses. Pulses also restricted, they should not take much food also. Food.
What are some effects of uncontrolled diabetes?
I told you, the blood sugar is uncontrolled, the sugar will involve all the organs of the body, from hair to the toes. It can affect heart, it can affect your eye, it can affect kidney, it can affect skin, it can affect also some coronary vessels, major vessels and minor vessels in the body.
What is the importance of World Diabetes Day?
I see this World Diabetes Day is celebrated from 1991, 14 November. The insulin was discovered in 1921 on 14 November, the official declaration of the insulin discovery by International Diabetes Federation. It has been discovered by Banting and Best in Toronto in a lab. The first man got the insulin is your Leopold Thompson. He was a 14 years old boy who was suffering from type 1 diabetes. He was about to die, so insulin was given. In those days, it was not very much pure insulin. The patient survived, and he continued to live up to 13 years from the day he has started insulin. He died at the age of 27 years, and because of pneumonia, he died. In those days, as I told you, there was no pure insulin. The insulin actually name was given by Professor McLeod in those days, and insulin extraction, purity, more pure insulin was devised by Dr. Colley. And also, in those days, insulin was discovered, insulin was available in the market. Dr. Lawrence, a London doctor, London physician, he survived. He was suffering from type 1 diabetes. Later on, Dr. Lawrence has started British Diabetes Association, the landmark association in the world for diabetes education for the people. In those days, Professor Elliot Joslin was working in Boston. He, in the first year of the discovery of insulin, he treated near about 261 of the diabetic patients, and he gave mass importance of diabetic patients for systemic complications and what is diabetes. They should know some sort of getting the control of the diabetes mellitus. And he was the most eminent diabetologist of the 20th century in the world.
How it is celebrated?
You see, the 14th November is being celebrated in 160 countries as World Diabetes Day. The motto of the World Diabetes Day is to educate and alert the patients and patients' family members regarding diabetes mellitus the complications, and they should know how to prevent the complications. How to prevent the complications? See, in the treatment, if you try to closely monitor the blood glucose as far practical to the normal patients, there is some more episode of low blood sugar. We call it hypoglycemia. The patient should be aware of the symptoms of the hypoglycemia, and also patient family member should be aware of the symptoms of hypoglycemia. They should take active part in the patient's awareness program, and they should also be able to treat hypoglycemia at the onset so that the complications are averted. In a very severe episode of hypoglycemia, even the patient may die. So the World Diabetes Day is to educate and aware the patients, and this has been done in performing a rally, a TV show, educational program for the patients, and also by poster and leafleting, and also by giving some your educative materials published in newspapers, and also in the print and your electronic media.
Do you feel that there is something in your knowledge of diabetes that more people need to be aware?
Yes, people should be aware of the diabetes mellitus, yes, because it is an epidemic disease, and 10% of the population is suffering from the diabetes. In India, you know, if one patient is diagnosed as having diabetes, there will be about 4 patients in the society having diabetes but not diagnosed. So the near 40% of the people are expected to suffer from diabetes in India. Whereas in the European country, if there is one patient diagnosed, there are expected to be 2 patients remain in the society undiagnosed. So the prevalence is very high, so therefore the patient should be aware of, and people should be aware of, so some knowledge on diabetes mellitus.
Any message for the people?
Yes. Message is, if the blood sugar is under well control, diabetes mellitus is not a grave disease. People should try to control the blood glucose as near to normal people. If they control it, there will be late onset of the complications, and the progression of the complications will also be delayed. And they should also know some education regarding the management of the diabetes mellitus, how they should take the drug, diet, exercise, and also they should know how to prevent the complications or delay the onset of the diabetes mellitus, and also they should conquer diabetes mellitus. They should live healthy and hearty. Further, I would like to tell you that a diabetic patient can live a normal life. Even their longevity may be more than the person not having diabetes mellitus, because they are under close observation and under close investigations of physicians. They are physicians. So any sort of complications are detected early and treated early. There are many people across the world having diabetes mellitus, performed well, went to the top of their life. In India, you see, there is Kamal Hassan, is so active, man, film star. He is having diabetes mellitus. In Pakistan, Washim Akram is also having diabetes mellitus. He gives some sort of advertisement in the TV for your blood glucose meter.
Thank you, doctor, and thank you for being with us.